To make sacred geometry work in this plane, it's best to have it rotating. And this particular shape, when it rotates, it generates a field of divine love, which is just so wonderful to work in. It's so pure, so it's really, really great. So if you do get a form, make sure that you get something to a motor of some sort, because you want it spinning so that you can work in that field. When you move one field through another field, that creates the flow of energy, just like any generator does.
And when you are working with spinning, there are two different directions. If you spin it looking from above, you always look from outside in when you determine the direction of the spin, versus from inside out, we reverse things as a human being. That's what we do with astrology. So in this case, when it from above, it's spinning clockwise, it's moving energy into this dimension from the higher dimensions and helping us move energy in that way. When you spin it counterclockwise from above, it's bringing energy up from the earth, and that has many positive benefits as well. But when you move that energy up from the earth into the higher dimensions, that's sometimes used for cleansing, for moving energy up out of the system, and clockwise is moving energy into the system.
And this is just classic working with energy, classic physics 101, right hand rule. You have your hand going, your fingers pointing in the direction of the energy flow. From above, this would be counterclockwise. Your thumb points in the direction of where the energy is going. So when you go like this, the energy is going up. Right hand rule, clockwise from above, the energy is coming down.
Absolutely.
Classic, every engineering student knows, right hand rule.
Because that's what happens with electricity and the way electrons start flowing in wires in the field that they generate, that we can measure as a magnetic field when energy flows.